Hello, I'm Peter Boxall, and I'm going to say a few words of introduction to Chapter 11 of Strategy and Human Resource Management. This is the final chapter in four, which is concerned with the mega contexts of HRM. And here we are adding a further level of complexity over the top of multi-divisional firms. We're talking about multinational firms and their HR strategies. These firms are typically multi-divisional, which was the topic in the previous chapter. But now we add a further level of complexity. They're operating across multiple societies with different employment laws, different labour markets, different social customs. The chapter examines the nature of strategies in multinational firms. Very often they're seeking out new markets. Very often they're seeking more efficient use of resources. Very often they're finding ways to operate more cost effectively. And we look at their structures, including the ways in which they're embedded in global value chains. That's an important term which is used in this chapter. And the chapter illustrates the different nature of a variety of global value chains. We then look at what's distinctive about HR strategy in multinationals, because obviously it must be in certain key ways. One of the key debates over many years is the extent to which multinationals might try to manage in a certain way around the world or might adapt to their local circumstances. And as you'll read the chapter, you'll see that we argue that multinationals are inevitably forced to adapt to local circumstances to survive and to prosper in particular societies. Yes, they may have policy frameworks. Yes, they may have global footprints. But inevitably, there are different employment laws. There are different labour markets. There are different social customs to adjust to. And expatriate managers learn very quickly that these are things that one must come to terms with. We then look at the whole issue of the social legitimacy of multinational behaviour, because another major issue about them is whether they're exploiting labour, particularly in the third world. Are multinationals complying with the conventions of the International Labour Organization? Are they observing good codes of practice? What are their responses to major disasters in employee safety? For example, the Rana Plaza disaster. How do they deal with this? Multinationals, in fact, are under a high level of scrutiny for their behaviour in global value chains. This clearly makes a major difference to how they approach their HRM. And then finally, we make the point that multinationals are involved in extensive efforts to develop human talent. Clearly, if an organisation is operating across multiple boundaries, its managers need to be very skilled in dealing with different cultures and languages, in cooperating across social boundaries. And so multinationals often invest significant resources in management development and in the development of their most critical groups of employees across functions, across businesses, and across countries. So then, in summary, there are ongoing questions about the legitimacy of multinational behaviour. What impact do they have on the workforces of the world? But bear in mind at the same time that multinationals are the world's most sophisticated organisations in terms of developing managerial and scientific capabilities. So most governments and societies regard it as helpful to have a large number of multinationals headquartered in their country because their processes of human resource development are regarded as highly valuable.